Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/APOD. And today's picture for January the 1st of 2020, well, it is titled Betelgeuse Imagined. So what do we see here? Well, this is an artist's conception of the star Betelgeuse. Betelgeuse is one of the brightest stars in the constellation of Orion. However, very recently, it has dimmed pretty drastically. In fact, only about half the brightness over just the last 6 months or so. So it's very well known in Orion, the star at the upper left of Orion, as we look at it in the northern hemisphere, and a distinct red star, a red supergiant star. So why might it be dimming? Well, that's one of the things we really don't know, is why it happens to be fading. We have some basic understandings of the stars, but to understand exactly how they work, there's a lot of complexities and things going on there that could be causing this. Now, Betelgeuse is a star towards the end of its life and is the type of star that we expect to go supernova. So could this be a precursor to that, or could it be just something as getting ready and we might have thousands of years before Betelgeuse actually explodes? Now, when we look at the image, we can get an idea of the immense size of this star. Our sun is pictured there as well, off to the right-hand side, and as well as the planets within our solar system. And Betelgeuse, to scale there, will then fill our entire inner solar system. In fact, the outer atmosphere of the star would reach close to Jupiter, 5 astronomical units away from the sun, the Earth being 1 astronomical unit away. So if we could somehow put Betelgeuse in the place where our sun is right now, we would be inside the star, and the only planets that would exist would be those more distant ones well out in the outer solar system, and even they would likely be affected by this because of the intense storms from the sun and violent solar flares as the star reaches the end of its life. Now, what happens when it becomes a supernova? Well, first of all, it will build up iron in its core, and that's what we don't know, is once it gets to that stage, things will progress pretty rapidly. But Betelgeuse could be thousands, tens of thousands, or hundreds of thousands of years away from that time. So when it does, it will explode, and it will become one of the brightest objects in the sky. Betelgeuse being about 700 or so light years away from us is relatively close, but not too close, fortunately, for a supernova. It would become extremely bright. It's one of the brighter stars in the sky right now. It would be brighter than the planet Venus and actually rivaling the brightness of the full moon. So still would not be near as bright as our sun, but when you consider how much further away this is, it's amazing amount of energy that is being put out. And in fact, a supernova going off nearby could be quite dangerous to life on Earth. If someone were to go off within about 50 light years, that would likely wipe out life on Earth. The intense energy, even 50 light years away, would be amazingly intense and could sterilize the Earth's surface. Even out to 100 light years, it would still be pretty damaging and could cause mass extinctions. But at Betelgeuse's distance, the radiation will be spread out enough that we'll still get to see the bright show, but without it having a significant effect of life here on Earth. But of course, as I say, when it happens is really anybody's guess. We can tell, we know the process by which we think this will happen. However, when is a very tough thing to see, because what is happening is deep down inside the core of the star, and that is something that we cannot observe, although in our image for today, we can actually get an idea of perhaps what Betelgeuse looks like and what it would be like if you were to be relatively close to this star. So that was our picture of the day for January the 1st of 2020. It was titled Betelgeuse Imagined. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture. So until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.